heritage. What is the first image that strikes your imagination when you hear this word? Is it something tangible like Kaunas modernism architecture or Vilnius Baroque churches? Or is it something intangible like Baltic song and dance celebrations? Think of it. For me, heritage is people, the communities. And you might probably think, why do I put communities in the center of the process called heritage? Well, at first, it might seem simple. Without communities, no memory. And without memory, there's no possibility for sustainable development. However, there's no simplicity at all. And let me tell you why. In 2015, the United Nations adopted the Agenda 2030. There are 17 goals to transform our world. 17 sustainable development goals, among which is the 11th goal, which encourages us to make cities sustainable, resilient, safe, and inclusive. From national parks in Africa to the ancient city of Aleppo in Syria. It is the main task and the main target of the SDG 11 to protect the world's cultural and natural heritage. And then another question comes. Who is the worst enemy and the biggest friend for heritage? Can somebody tell me? Yes, it is people. Therefore, to avoid the danger that might be done to the cultural heritage, we, the community, should become the keystones in the decision-making process. For the different parts of the world, the state parties that have adhered to the World Heritage Convention face various problems in World Heritage sites. That is, floods, earthquakes, abusive tourism, uncontrolled urbanism, pollution, ignorance, and war. There are 54 sites in the world that are included into the World Heritage List in danger. And most of them, even 41%, are in Arab states. Aleppo, once a peaceful and beautiful city in Syria, now is a city in ruins. War destroyed even 6 World Heritage sites in Syria, and therefore the international community is called on action for the emergency safeguarding of the world's heritage. But then another question comes, how can you protect your heritage and your history when you have the war inside your country? It is still an open question. As history has already shown us, the will of the nation might become the crucial point in protecting your heritage and safeguarding your history. And the proof of it is the Polish people, who brought back up to life the city of Warsaw, of which even 85% were destroyed during 1944, during the Second World War. Since wars begin in the minds of men, it is in the minds of men that the defenses of peace must be constructed, the preamble of the Constitution of the UNESCO says. Primum non nocere, first do no harm. And in this point, I want you to think about our beautiful capital city, Vilnius, with this historic urban landscape, the old town that was included into UNESCO World Heritage List, with its Baroque, classical style churches, and some invasions that are being made today. It is not the question of protection for the sake of protecting. It is the question of sustainable using and sustainable development, and about the ways in which phase and when should the community be involved. The future generations have the right for heritage. Therefore, now we, the community, should become the custodians for heritage. You might think, how? And I will tell you, by a participatory approach, by discussions, by mutual respect and understanding, by our responsibility and commitment of preserving heritage. And what is the most important thing? By building our personal relationship with heritage. Thank you.